Hi everyone, I'm Ellie and I'm your instructor for today and welcome to Code of the Future. So today we're going to kickstart your coding journey by installing and downloading Python. So obviously you can see here that I'm on a Mac. Now the installation process is very similar regardless of what laptop you're on. Now Macs actually already have Python installed in them, however we still do need to install Python separately just because the version that Macs already have installed on them isn't really sufficient. You don't really want to be programming in that type of version. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So if I just type in terminal, so here we are, we've opened up the terminal and you type in Python dash dash version and press enter. Now what this does is it shows you the type of version that Python has installed already on the Mac. So what you'll see is Python is actually installed a 2.7.16. Now, ideally, we want to be coding in Python 3, which is why we're going to install it onto the Mac. This is just to show you that Python is actually installed on Mac. So you could do something with Python 2.7.16, but we kind of advise you not to, just because Python 3 is a lot better. So that was just a bit of a side note to show you that Python is already installed on your Mac, but we want to improve the version. So what you're going to do is you're going to go straight into Google Chrome or Safari or whatever web browser you have. So we're going to use Anaconda for Python. It's completely free, so don't worry, all of this is free. You don't have to stress about paying for subscriptions or anything like that. And Anaconda actually comes with over 400 packages for Python. Personally, I think Anaconda is the best thing to install just because of the packages, and it comes with a variety of different things included on Anaconda. But at the end, I will show you two extra things you can install, PyCharm and Visual Studio Code, but I'll get onto them later on in the video. So what we're just going to do is we're going to type in www.anaconda, mine's already there because I've been looking before. If I can spell downloads, that'd be great, I can't see. /downloads. So it comes up with the Anaconda page and essentially you just go here and click download. So if you want to give a bit of a read, this gives you a bit more about what Anaconda's about. This is what will be installed, as you can see here, and it's just, this whole web page gives you a bit more of an in-depth about what Anaconda is. So if you want to give that a read, then give it a read, but I'm just going to do the quick installation and downloading. So we click download, it takes you down here. So if you have a Windows, then you know, you choose which one you want. If you have a Mac, you choose one you want, and if you have Linux, you choose the one you want. Okay, so because I'm on a Mac, obviously I'm gonna go for Mac OS, and we're just gonna click the graphical installer. Okay, so as you can see here, it's downloaded. Now what you want to do is click on this and it's going to open it, and it'll pop up with this message. So this package will run a program to determine if the software can be installed, and that's fine. We click continue, and then you just go through this whole installation process. Very simple. We click continue and you get to this section. Now these are all the packages that are going to be installed on this version. So as you can see, there's a lot, but in Python you need a lot of packages to be installed so you can do the data analysis and the coding and everything that you need to be doing. So we're just going to click continue. Going to click continue again. This is just the agreement, so click agree. It tells you how much space it will take up on your computer, so I advise before you install Python to have a bit of space on your computer. So we click install. Now I'm just going to enter my Touch ID. You enter your password at this point, and then it's just doing the whole installation. Now while that's loading, I'm just going to say again, if you are a bit unfamiliar about what Python does, what kind of things are involved, obviously this video is just going to be the very simple downloading and installing Python, but I have made another video about what Python is, what kind of things you can do with Python. So if you are really interested, I would recommend just checking that video out. When we start Anaconda up, it'll show you some packages that get involved. So one of them is Spider. Now Spider is something that I learned when I was learning at university, so I learned how to program on Spider. I think Spider's great, and I will do a video on how you can use Spider. I personally like to use PyCharm, and a lot of other people love PyCharm as well, so I'm going to show you how to install PyCharm. It would like to access my downloads folder, okay. I'm going to do all my tutorials on PyCharm because I love PyCharm and I think everyone should use PyCharm. So I'm going to do three separate videos. I'm going to show you how to use Spider, PyCharm, and then Visual Studio Code. So those are three different things you can code on. It has installed on my laptop, So here it says, working with Python and Jupyter Notebooks is a breeze with PyCharm Professional. See, this is what I'm on about. This is PyCharm. So I'm going to do that separately. Okay, so it says, thank you for installing, and we're going to close it. I move it to the bin, just saves a bit of a storage on here. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go onto my apps. So these are all my apps. What you'll notice here, if you have Anaconda Navigator, you'll find this in your application. So we'll just click on Anaconda Navigator. So it's just loading everything at the moment. Okay, here, so what this is just saying is it's going to gather usage information just to help improve Anaconda. I always click OK and don't show again. It's loading some more content, so I just put OK and don't show again. I'm not, you know, I'm happy for them to improve Anaconda. So what you'll see here is this is the Anaconda Navigator. Right, so we have a few things installed. So Spider, as I mentioned, which is one of the IDEs that you can program on. Again, Jupyter, Jupyter Notebooks, Jupyter Lab, RStudio. I will do a bit of a video on mainly Spider, but if it would be useful for everyone watching at home, then I will do a separate video on just explaining what each of these things are, but they are just different IDEs. So RStudio, I used RStudio in statistics for my statistics module, so that's programming statistics. So this is all we need to know. This video is just the installation and downloading. So there we have it. We've installed these. You have Spider there. You can click launch. I am doing a separate video, as I mentioned, how to use these. So if you've done this and then installed it and followed along, then go check out those following videos that explain exactly how you use Spider. But for now, I'm just going to show you how to install PyCharm and Visual Studio Code. They're both very simple. And what you'll find is they will actually pop up on here as well on Anaconda. Fingers crossed if I do it correctly. So we're going to go back onto Google and we're going to download and we're going to just type in download PyCharm. So we're just going to click community, we're going to click download. Okay, so there we are, it's downloading. There we are, it's downloaded Python. We're just going to click on downloaded PyCharm. I'm just going to open this up. Again, you know, I do a lot of talking in these videos, but the actual download and installation is so simple. So here we're just going to get PyCharm CE and we're going to drag it to applications. I've just accidentally opened that. So it's copying over. So when I click on my applications, PyCharm should be here somewhere. There it is. So I'm going to open up PyCharm. And yeah, we want to open it. I'm going to allow notifications. We're just going to minimize that. So I confirm, continue, yeah, I'm going to send anonymous statistics, and here we go. This is PyCharm. Now, as I said, I'm going to do a video on how to use this, so, you know, all of this will be explained in another video, so we're just going to cross off it for now. So you have downloaded PyCharm, it's there, it's here. I'm just going to cross off it. So now I'm going to go and install Visual Studio Code. Now, Visual Studio Code, I use this more for when it comes to web development, so when we move on to the web development tutorials and stuff, because I'm hoping to teach you how to make your own website. But that will come later once I've done a few Python videos, because I think Python is the easiest language to learn. So now we've downloaded PyCharm, we're just going to type in Visual Studio, I've already typed it in, code, download. Okay, here, download Visual Studio Code. Here again, you get the option to download it for different. So Linux, Windows, Mac. Obviously I'm Mac, so I click download. Anyway, the installation is downloaded, so we're gonna click on the installation. There we are, Visual Studio Code. So we're gonna open it up. And we're gonna click open. And here we are, this is Visual Studio Code. So perfect, it's downloaded. So what we're going to do is we're going to take Visual Studio Code from downloads and move it into our things, which means then when you go to do this on a Mac, here it is, Visual Studio Code. So I'm hoping now if I open Anaconda, it may be there. Again, it's not the end of the world if it's not, because we'll just open it up straight from applications. But it's quite handy when you open up Anaconda because, there we go, VS Code. I'm not quite sure why this has moved all the way over there, but it has anyway. So there you go, you have your PyCharm, Spider and VS Code. So PyCharm is the IDE that I'm going to be doing most of my tutorials on for Python. And then again, Visual Studio Code is when we'll move on to the web development, but you know, we're not moving straight onto there just yet. So there we have it, we've installed Spider, which is what I learned on when I first started coding, PyCharm and Visual Studio Code. So if you like the video, then please like, subscribe and comment, and I hope you'll join me in the next video where we continue your journey to learn how to code.